voltaic cell. Usually in SBM we call it voltaic cell, but in some other book, maybe the book O levels, A levels book, okay, or maybe from internet, sometimes, okay, it's called the galvanic cell, okay. So it's either voltaic cell or galvanic cell. So both voltaic cell and galvanic cell is the same, okay, just two different names only. Okay, but in SPM usually we call it voltaic cell. Before this we have discussed electrolytic cell, right? Electrolytic cell. And for electrolytic cell, what is the change of energy? Can any of you tell me what is the conversions of energy in electrolytic cell? Conversions of energy in electrolytic cell? From electrical energy to chemical energy. That's correct. That's correct. Okay. So in every electrolytic cell, this is electrolytic cell. You can see this is electrolytic cell. Okay, then you can see a battery, right? Okay, this is a battery. Okay, so this battery supplies electrical energy, and then the electrical energy causes the chemical reactions to occur here. So this is from electrical energies to chemical energy. So this is electrolytic cell. Then how about voltaic cell? Voltaic cell is the opposite. It converts chemical energy into electrical energy. Means that voltaic cell, it can produce electrical energy. Okay, or it can produce EMF or produce electric currents by using a chemical. So we use chemicals to produce current, okay, in voltaic cell. So voltaic cell converts chemical energy to electrical energy. Okay, so this is very important because this is asked quite often in tests or exam. Okay, they will ask you what's the conversions of energy in electrolytic cell or the conversions energy in voltaic cell. So you must know this. Okay, so that's the very first thing that you need to know about voltaic cell. Okay, now let's start with a simple voltaic cell. In a simple voltaic cell, there is two metal plates. Okay, and it must be metal plates. It must be metal plates in this simple voltaic cell. Why I stress on this? Because in Form 4, you only learn voltaic cell. But in Form 5, in the third chapter called oxidations and reductions, you are going to learn a cell which is very similar to voltaic cell. Okay? But in that cell, we do not use metals. Instead, we use carbon. We use the carbon in the cell. That one is also we convert chemical energies to electrical energy. Okay? So we use chemicals to produce electricity. It's very similar, but the structure is not the same, okay? But in Form 4, you only learn voltaic cell, okay? And in the voltaic cell, you have two pieces of metals, two metal plates. These two metal plates, okay, it must be two different metals. You cannot use same metals, okay? You cannot use both both coppers or both irons, cannot, okay? The two plates must be two different metals, okay? And these two metals are immersed in an electrolyte. That is about the structures of this simple voltaic cell, okay? Let's say we have two pieces of metals. Usually we use zinc and copper as the examples. This is a simple voltaic cell, okay? And this is electrolyte. This is electrolyte, two pieces of metals. And then so you see the major difference between voltaic cell and electrolytic cell is electrolytic cell, we have a battery here. Just now I show you, right? Okay. But for voltaic cell, there's no battery because this cell itself is a battery. Okay. It produces electricity. So this is a battery. So you don't need battery. Okay. So we use chemicals to produce electricity. Out of these two metals, okay, they're two pieces of metals, right? The very first things that you need to know is which one will become the negative terminal, because for the cell it must have a positive and negative terminal. Okay, cell is like a battery, it has a positive or a negative terminal. Okay, and the very first thing that you need to know about a voltaic cell is which one will be the negative terminal. How do we know which one will become a negative terminal? Okay, so this statement says that the metal which is higher in electrochemical series will become the negative terminal. If you see two pieces of metals, then you must try to recall, okay, which one is higher in, tell me, which one is higher, zinc and copper, which one is higher in electrochemical series? That's correct. Okay, that's correct. So zinc is higher in electrochemical series compared to copper, and therefore these metal plates or these electrodes will become the negative terminal. Okay, you become the negative terminal. So this one will be the negative terminal, and this one will be the positive terminal. So that's what you need to know. The metal which is higher in electrochemical series will become the negative terminal. Okay. The atom of the metal which is higher in electrochemical series will release electron to form negative ions. Now, for the case that we discussed just now, okay, zinc. We have zinc and copper, right? Okay. During the chemical reactions, atoms of zinc, which is higher in electrochemical series compared to coppers, the ion of zinc, it will give away electrons. It will release electrons. And the electron release will move to the other metal plates. So the electron release will go to the copper plate. Okay, we'll go to the copper plates through the wire, because we have a wire, right? So there's a wire connects to the galvanometers. Okay, so the electrons release, it will go through the wires, okay, and then go to the another metal plate. Okay, so that's what happening. That's also important for you to know. Okay, the metal which is higher in electrochemical series will release electrons. Okay, it will release electrons, and the electrons will go to the other metal plate through the wire. The metal which is lower in electrochemical series will become the positive terminal. I think should be no problems, right? Because the one higher is the negative terminal, the lower must be the positive terminal. Because in a voltaic cell, we must have positive and negative terminal, okay? And in positive terminal, the electrons will be released to the positive ions in the electrolyte. So for example, so just now we have zinc, right? Zinc, and then now we have copper, okay? Electrolyte. So the zinc release electrons. So the electrons, it will move to copper. Okay, it will move to copper. So when the electrons move to copper, we must have something to receive the electrons. Okay, or else all the electrons accumulate here, then the flows of the electron will stop. Okay, so the electrons will be given to the positive ions, because there's in electrolyte there is a lot of ions, positive or negative ions, but the electrons will be given to the positive ions. The atoms of zinc release electrons, and then the electrons received by the positive ion. The electron is not received by the copper. Okay, some students think, okay, zinc release electron and copper receive electron. That's not true. Okay, zinc release electrons, but the electrons go to copper. It's not received by copper, because copper is a metal. The metals, usually they do not receive electron. They will release electron to form positive ion. They won't receive electrons. So the electron is not received by copper. Instead, it's received by the positive ions around the electrodes. Okay, it depends on what's the positive ions here. That's what you need to know about what happens around the positive terminal. The name of the two electrodes, okay? The negative terminal is the anode, while the positive terminal is the cathode. So this is the opposites of electrolytic cell, right? For electrolytic cell, okay, this is positive terminal, okay? So this is a positive electrode, this is a negative electrode, okay? And the positive electrode is called the anode, and the negative electrode is called a cathode, right? But for voltaic cell, okay, so you can see, this one it has battery, this one has no battery here, but instead there is just a galvanometer, okay? So this is called electrolytic cell. This is called a voltaic cell. Now, voltaic cell, the negative electrode is the anode, okay? And the positive electrode is the cathode, okay? Yeah? So you see, electrolytic cell, positive anode. Voltaic cell, negative anode. So electrolytic cell, negative is the cathode. Voltaic cell, positive is the cathode. Electrolytic cell is the cell where electrolysis occurs. Okay, that's what we discussed for the past 3 or 4 weeks. Okay, that's what we discussed, electrolytic cell. So today we discuss voltaic cell. So the anode cathode is not the same. It's not the same. Remember, electrolytic cell or electrolysis, okay, when there's a battery, okay, electrolytic cell, positive is the anode, Negative is a cathode. Voltaic cell, usually this is galvanometers or ammeters, okay, to measure current. For the voltaic cell, negative is anode and positive is the cathode. Why? From the definitions of anodes, anode is where the oxidation reactions occurs, and cathode is the place where reduction reactions occurs. You're going to learn oxidations and reductions in Form 5. Okay, so for Form 4 students, don't ask me what is oxidations and reductions now. You're going to learn it in Form 5. So for electrolytic cell, oxidations happen here. So therefore, this is called anode. It happens at the positive electrode. But for voltaic cell, the oxidations occur here. That's why it's called anode. It's called anode, it's not because it's positive. Okay, it's called anode, it's because oxidations reactions occurs here. So that is the anode and cathodes for electrolytic cell or voltaic cell.